Hi guys, welcome back, and this is the 12th video of this series. In this video, I'll tell you how to create a bug in Jira. Before going forward, I want to give you an overview about bug. What is bug? So bug basically a defect in a computer program, or you can say bug refers to an error in computer program or hardware system. It produces an unexpected result basically. So this is the overview of a bug. And this video will be very useful for QA, quality analyst, tester and developers too, because suppose if you are a tester and you are testing a software application and you find a bug, then how will you log that bug in Jira tool or maybe any other bug tracking tool? In this video, I'll tell you only in Jira how you will log your bug in Jira. If you are a tester and you find a bug and you want to log that bug in Jira, then it is a very best practice for you to track the status, the exact status of your bug, so that you can see what's happening about the bug in the current sprint and what kind of work is required from the developer side as well. Because if you know the exact status, you can track your bug more efficiently. For creating the bug in Jira, we will go to our Jira Cloud instance. This is our cloud instance, and you can see I have a project A. So I want to create a bug in a project A. Suppose this is our software application, and right now I am a tester and I am testing this application, and suddenly I got an error, or you can say defect or a bug. Now I want to log that bug into Jira. Then how I will do this? So there are three ways to log the bug in Jira, as like the issues, the other issue types. If you haven't seen my video yet, how to create the issue in Jira, then please go back to this series and see the previous video so that you can know about that different three ways. Here I will tell you again, you can create a bug from the backlog. Once you will click, you can choose the issue type which is bug. So bug is a default issue type in Jira which comes when you create your project. Okay, so this is the first way. You can go and choose the bug issue type. You can write down the title of your bug, something like this, or whatever you want, and just press enter and the bug will automatically log into Jira. And the second way is this plus icon. Once you will click, it will open a window where you can choose the project under which project you want to create the bug. Right now I have only one project, so it's showing me only one. But in your Jira instance, let's suppose if you have the 50 project, or maybe 500 or 600 and whatever, maybe thousands of the project you have, so you can choose your project from the drop down. And the second drop down is related to the issue type. You can see we have a issue type bug here. You can choose, you can write the summary, you can write the description. And if I would like to say this is the best practice for a tester, if he and she can attach a screenshot of the bug so that developer can understand the bug more easily, right? So like this, you can also create the bug. And the other option is just press the C key, C for cat, cat C from your keyboard, and it will open the same window as just like when we pressed or when we clicked this plus icon. Similarly, you will perform the same steps. You will select the project, you will select the issue types, and you will write a summary. Let's suppose after clicking on submit button, I am not able to find any action, right? You can write the same description in the description box. You can attach any image, okay, from here. So it will give you options to browse the image from your computer. And if you want to give any reference, and you want to put any link, then you can do it from here. It is giving you three options. You can put the external link, main link, or anchor link. So it's up to you. And when you will scroll down, you can choose the priority of the bug as well. Let's suppose the priority is high, highest, low, and lowest. You can mention any label of your bug. The label will help you to search your bug in future. So it's up to you. If you want, then it's good. And you can write about the environments. Environment means it is related to any operating system, software platform, or maybe any specific hardware specification. Let's suppose my submit button is working on operating system Windows and on Chrome browser, but it is not working on operating system Linux, on Ubuntu, and on Firefox. This kind of information which is related to the bug, you can mention in this environment field. So you can attach or you can drop your image here as well. Let's suppose if this particular bug is related to, or maybe it is blocked by, or maybe it is cloned by with the other issues or with the other bugs, or let's suppose if this is relates to any issue, then you can type the issue key here and it will automatically link. You can assign that bug to the concerned person. If this bug is related to any epic, then you can choose the epic name and you can mention the sprint name as well. And after doing these things, let's suppose you want to add some more field, then you can see this is the configure field options where you can go and you can mention the other fields as well. Let's suppose you don't want to keep this sprint option, so you can simply uncheck this and you can see here there is the no sprint option here. You can simply press the create button and here is our bug which is logged into the backlog of our project. So this is the way how we log the bug in Jira. Jira provides the default workflow for a bug. In the coming session, this series, I'll tell you how can we customize the workflow for the issues. It could be for a bug, for a story, for task, and for any other custom issue types as well. So in this series, I'll cover this part as well. Right now, I'm just covering the things from the user perspective, the end user perspective, but I'll cover some administrative parts as well. So I will recommend just create your cloud instance and do the practice. How can you do this? And if you have any queries, then please feel free to ask me into the comment box. I hope you like this video. And if this video is helpful, then please press the like button and please share this video to the needful person. If, let's suppose, if your colleague or your friends have the QA background and they are not aware about how to create the bug into Jira, then please feel free to share that. And please subscribe and press the bell icon so that you can get a notification for my new videos. Thank you. Thanks for watching.